When we were casting and Ridley was looking at different actors, I made him sit down in a screening room and look at Katie Tipple, Soldier of Orange, and Turkish Delight. And I said, this is Batty. I mean, you've got to realize that. And he said, absolutely. And he actually cast Rutger without ever having met him.
He came in, because he's always a weird dresser, this guy. He was a big man, and he was wearing a puce nylon jumpsuit with one piece zip up.
A Kenzo sweater that had a big fox across the shoulder with two red eyes. He had already cut his hair in the way he thought Batty should look, which was the short pointed blonde hair.
And he was wearing green floral kind of Elton John sunglasses.
We're so happy you found us.
I could literally see Ridley's heart stop.
This is gonna be my tough guy. And I...
and I said, Ridley, I can assure you that the guy is Batty. And of course, obviously, it was, you know, Rutger playing a joke on Ridley, or maybe he wasn't.
Then I had a meeting with Ridley. You only have that a few times in your life. You talk about all kinds of stuff, and you're having a good lunch. And you never get to the subject. And it doesn't really matter that much. But I think at the end I said, Ridley, so what about this Blade Runner? What does it look like? He said, well, you know, one of the major influences for me is Bilal, which is a cartoonist in France. And I happen to know that cartoon. And I went, whoa. The talk about character was, I think it was almost in the second talk we had before I got signed on, where I explained to him, you know, what I thought would be interesting for the character. And basically saying, you know, can I put in all the things that don't belong there? The things that are so amazing about people, you know, sense of poetry, sense of humor, sense of sexuality, sense of the kid, sense of soul. And really said, you know, I like all of them. Keep them in. We'll work with them. When we'll find a way to get them out in different scenes. I have a great rapport with stunt guys because of this, you know, because I ride horses, I fence, I do some martial arts and that sort of stuff. And I always watch them, see how they prepare, watch what they do.
It might have been 30 feet from the floor to the top, so we had an airbag at the bottom, so if you didn't make it, and if I remember correctly, the guy that doubled Rutger, the first jump he made, he didn't make it. He hit and bounced off and went to the airbag.
Another stunt guy comes in. He does the same thing. And now we're at 5 o'clock in the morning. We have got an hour. And I'm saying to Ridley, if you put the building, and the building wears on wheels, if you give me a foot closer, I swear, you know, it's not a problem for me. I can do this. And he's desperate by now. So he goes, okay, let's do it. And then, you know, we did one take and I jumped.
Rutger just did one big bargy hop.
What if I take a dove with me and then when I die, I just hold on to the dove for the last bits. And then when I die, I just let it go and that's it. You know, that was sort of the visual part of, you know, death. There was a real page of opera talk that, you know, is bad in any script. I don't care how you look at it. And this was high-tech speak that had very little bearing on anything, you know, that the movie had shown you before. So I just put a knife in it. And I did this at night, and I didn't know if Ridley was okay with it.
There's no way.
Like most actors, aware that, you know, this is his death scene coming up, this is his kind of moment, and they suddenly start getting pretty tenacious about what they want to shoot and what they want to have covered. And I think he was, you know, he was quite demanding at that time of Ridley.
I came up with, you know, two lines that I had some sort of off-worldly feel to it and some poetry in it. And then I came up with the line, at 4 o'clock in the morning, all those moments will be lost in time like tears of rain. And I brought it to the set and really liked it.
Rutger is big and bold and
and interesting as an actor. It was, I had a great time working with him. Some of the scenes we had together are some of the most satisfying professional moments I've ever had. And I think the two characters depend on each other in a dramatic sense. So I was very grateful to have his capacity and his strength and his focus to work with.
When Roy Batty finally finds his 4-year lifespan is up and he dies with this wonderful dove in his lap, the dove that they had got wet and because of all this constant rain, and when he was releasing it to let it go, the dove was so wet it couldn't fly. So instead of like flying up off of Rutger's lap into the sky and then following it up, the dove literally just hopped out of his lap and waddled across the roof out of the frame. So they weren't able to use that.